Release.
This is ignited.
Confirm Newton 3 engine startup.
The team at Virgin Orbit tested their air launch system a few days ago by launching a rocket from a plane. The rocket was carrying 10 shoebox-sized satellites that will be used for space research.
Marcus talked about this in Trending the other day, and so we wanted to talk to the source here. Joining us now to tell us more about it is Virgin Orbit Chief Test Pilot Kelly Latimer. Thanks so much for being with us.
Sure, good morning.
So this is amazing. You know, I'm usually rockets are launched in the straight up and down position, aren't they? I'm not a space expert, but I'm wondering how they even do this, launching rockets from under the wing of a plane.
Yeah, it's an incredible challenge because you're right. Most rockets just launch vertically. And what we do is we essentially take the rocket, lob it in the middle of the air and tell it to go fly. So just a huge success the other day that we've made it happen. But it helps the rocket because what we do is we basically release it at a higher energy state. You can have a smaller, lighter, higher performance rocket versus what you would have from the ground.
Huh.
Is the idea to make this cheaper? What is the benefit for us?
Absolutely. It's to make it cheaper. So you can actually make a lighter, smaller rocket. You can mass produce it. And anytime you can mass produce something and make it in large numbers, you can make it a lot more affordable. So that's the idea, is to make it affordable. The second one is the fact that you don't have to launch from the ground. We're in a 747, so we could launch from any runway anywhere. So you also add the ability to launch from anywhere around the world on a moment's notice.
And the idea is also that there's a big demand for low-cost satellites. Is that what these would be launching?
Exactly. So to put it on an airplane, it has to be a smaller rocket, so it can't take a very big payload. So the idea of this is we would be catering to that market that has just small satellites. So instead of having to wait on your schedule for a large launch to happen, we can launch these weekly, daily, all the time. And so you can say, hey, I've got this satellite. When can you get me on the schedule? And we'll say next month. So it makes it affordable. And also the schedule is very flexible.
So who owns these satellites? What do they do? And are you concerned that maybe we just have way too much space junk up there?
So the satellites are from a number of people. It's, you know, the ones we launched recently were from universities. So there's academic reasons. There's a lot of communication satellites that go up there. You can have a number of these very small satellites where you're not relying on just one or two satellites, but you have sort of a web of many of them. And then if one or two goes out, you're able to replace them at a time, but it doesn't take your entire system out. You can also use it for Earth observation, environmental uses. So there's users across the realm for small satellites. And as far as the space in space, it is extremely large up there. These are all very small, but there is a tracking system that whenever we launch, you know, we have to make sure that we know exactly when we're launching, where we're launching. We have windows that we can't launch in because of other vehicles up in space. So it's all tracked, but there's still a lot of room up there.
So Kelly, I mean, if I wanted to launch a satellite to spy on Larry, I couldn't just pay you, you know, $500 and you'd send up a satellite. I'm assuming.
Right. No, it'll be, I mean, the cost will be somewhere in the, you know, 10 to 18 million, which is actually a lot cheaper than it is right now.
I was just a little bit off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, this is.
And the idea is also, as we get going and have many users and launch more satellites, that cost will come down, you know, further and further as we do this more often.
How cool to be a part of this. I mean,
It's been an amazing journey. I mean, I've been with it since we first got, our name of our airplane is Cosmic Girl. She actually came to us from Virgin Atlantic and she was in service there and that was her name. And so I've been with it since we got that aircraft, did the modifications, set up the stations, you know, flew with just a water-filled object under the wing to start with all the way till launch. It's been an amazing journey and the team is absolutely incredible. I mean, the engineers, launch engineers, the pilots, the flight crew, the pad crew. It's an incredible team, and everybody is just still, I think we're still a little bit over the moon from our success on Sunday.
That's great.
Well, thanks, Kelly.
Thanks so much for being with us. For more information, you go to virginorbit.com. You can also follow them on Twitter at the address on your screen. Thank you.
We're still trying to figure out how to get a live shot to Wrigleyville.
Yeah,